Let's take a look at the atomic structure for phosphorus, that's P, on the periodic table. And we're going to use a Bohr diagram, also called a Bohr model here, to help us visualize that. So phosphorus on the periodic table, its atomic number is 15. The atomic number, that tells us the number of protons. So we have our atomic number of 15. That means we have 15 protons right here in the nucleus of the phosphorus atom. Because this is a neutral atom, all the elements listed on the periodic table, they're listed as neutral. The number of protons equals the number of electrons. So we also have 15 electrons. And we're going to distribute those in these different energy levels around the phosphorus nucleus. Let's use the periodic table to help us do that. So we have 15 total electrons to put around the nucleus. So we go to the periodic table. Period 1, that's the first energy level here. It can only hold 1 and 2. Then it's full. So here are the 2 electrons we have in that first energy level. For period 2, this is the second energy level, we can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons. So we put them here in the second energy level. So far we've used 10. Remember we have 15. So we have 5 more electrons to put around the nucleus here. Third energy level, or third period here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And right here on the periodic table, that's where you find phosphorus. So we put these 5 electrons around in the third energy level. Third energy level, we have 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons. And these electrons are important. They're called valence electrons. They're the ones involved in chemical bonds. If you need help writing the electron configuration for phosphorus or finding the number of neutrons, there's a link at the end of this video. This is Dr. B with the Bohr diagram or Bohr model for the phosphorus atom. Thanks for watching.